Hello, I'm Marta, and this is 17th episode about rebuild of my DR350S. This time, we will rebuild the swing arm. Let's take a look how it was looking before. First, let's take everything apart. We remove the pin from both sides. Before that, we need to take out the clips. Now we unscrew two bolts to remove the swing arm plate. We repeat that on the opposite side. Next, we unscrew the chain cover plate. Now we take out three bolts holding the chain guide. Next, we unbolt two brake hose guides. We unscrew the grease nipples now. After that, we remove the bearing sleeve from the bearing. As you see, it looks nice and there are no signs of corrosion. To remove the drivetrain buffer, we need to unscrew two bolts on the upper and the bottom sides of the swing arm. At this stage, I also take out the swing arm pivot bolt. Now we can finally take out the drivetrain buffer and the second chain cover plate. We also remove two bearing covers, one from the drivetrain buffer and one from the swing arm. Now it's time for the cleaning. I use an engine cleaner and a brush. I forgot to remove the bearing sleeve, so I do it now. It looks like they are in good condition too. Here you can see all the parts after cleaning, including the swing arm linkage. To make swing arm looking fresh, I used a metal brush and I scrubbed it a little. Here's the effect after brushing. Now let's put everything back together. The ceilings in the old bearing covers were damaged and not fitting tightly to the swing arm, so I replaced them with the new ones. You can see here that the ceiling was worn out. The inner ceiling was okay, so I left it. Before mounting the ceiling, we grease everything a little. We do this for the opposite side too. Now we can slide in the bearing sleeves. I greased the covers, put the washer inside and mounted back on the swing arm. Now we will take care of the linkage. Again, before sliding in the bearing sleeve, we grease the bearing. Now I use a grease gun to grease the bearing by the grease nipple. When the grease comes out, you know the greasing is done. Before mounting the linkage to the swing arm, we check from which side we need to insert the bolts. There are also two spacing washers and we shouldn't forget about them. We tighten this nut according to this table from the user manual. We chose 90 Nm from the recommended range. After tightening, everything moves smooth. Now we mount back the drivetrain buffer. Before screwing in the bolts, we put on the washers on both sides. For those bolts, I also use a thread locking fluid. Next, we put back both swing arm plates. I also use thread locking fluid for this. Now we mount the chain cover plate. We put back in the pins and lock them with the clips. After assembly, we grease the pivot bearings with a grease gun. As before, when the new grease starts to come out from the bearing, the greasing is done. Now the swing arm is ready for installing. In the next episode, we will take care of the rear shock. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed, leave a like and stay tuned for the next videos documenting DR rebuilding.